Pundit, people, world, what's up, man? Back at it again. Hey, look, I told everybody, if you go watch them old videos, Uncle Joe, aka Joe Biden, I told you he was gonna try to do it. I told you. And for those who are just tuning in, I'm talking about the large capacity magazine ban. I'm talking about the AR-15 ban. Since they have the House, the Senate, and everything, they are going to try to push this agenda through. Whether or not it goes through or not, I don't know. But they are really, really going to try to push this through, man. I was reading some of the literature that they just put out, and Joe was talking about, hey, we're not going to wait for another Sandy Hook or another Columbine or another mass shooting to happen before we take action. And my thing is this. You can develop all of the gun laws that you want to, but does that still stop shootings and murders? Let's say in Memphis. Memphis have like 250, 260 murders, 240 murders. Does that still stop the murders in Chicago? Chicago had 500, 600, 700. One year they had like 900, almost 1,000. It doesn't stop no murders because, see, here's what you're failing to understand and realize. Criminals are not playing by the same rules that law-abiding citizens are playing by. They don't. You can make up a trillion goddamn gun laws and rules, and a criminal will never even think about motherfucking one. Because they don't play by the same rules, and they are not in the same guidelines that you want the general population to be into. You know, the gun laws are only going to hurt the people that can purchase guns legally, i.e. me and you, if you're legal. I know I'm legal, but I'm just saying, you and I, those laws will affect us the most. The criminals are still going to go and get the guns the same way that they have been getting them, whether it's breaking into cars and stealing them, or whether it's buying them in a back alley, or whether it's, you know, obtaining them through somebody that has got them and they brought them from them, they did a straw buy or something, you know. Those guys do not play by the same rules, so you will not be hurting them or crippling their organization or operation. They're going to still get the guns in their hands that they want. Now, the people like myself and other people is going to make it harder for us. So my thing is, just like I told you, be careful what you ask for. You just might get it. You want it, a Democratic majority, you got it. Democrats, see, Democrats have a way of tricking people that are not educated to see through their bullshit, or that don't have their third eye open to see through their bullshit. They like to use wording and rhetoric to get your gas turned up and get you fired up, man, ready to cook and everything. Democrats like big government, more taxes, you know. And here's my only thing. Hey, I'm the laziest motherfucker on the face of the earth. If I could figure out a way to get bigger than my problems and make more money so I could take care of my problems, I'm quite sure everybody else can figure that shit out too. I'm not special. None of that shit, man. But here's what I refuse to do. I refuse to be motherfucking an average motherfucker. I refuse to be a subpar motherfucker or below average motherfucker. So for the Democrats that want to, you know, create more revenue by creating more taxes, man, leave the money alone. People need their money. Just like everybody else can get up and go out here and work, the other people can too. Now, some people can't. You have some single mothers that might have child care issues or transportation issues, things like that, that probably can't do that. So they might need some help. Develop a special program for them. But everybody else that could get up and fend for themselves, man, let them get up and fend for themselves. You know, I was walking into the gas station the other day, and a guy, he asked me, he said, hey, man, hey, man, can you spare like a dollar or two? And I told him, I said, homie, I normally don't even give dudes no motherfucking money, man. I'll give a woman or a kid some money, but I normally don't give dudes no motherfucking money. Because just like you standing up out here, you could be standing up at McDonald's, Chili's, Walmart, Applebee's. You could be standing up at them places getting you some goddamn guaranteed money instead of hoping and wishing to get some motherfucking money from people that's, you know, walking by this way, walking by that way, man, you know. So when I came out, man, you know, I ain't been to church. I ain't gave no tithes or nothing. I just went on and gave the brother a couple of dollars, man. But I gave him an application, too. I went in and asked him for an application. I gave him an application, a couple of dollars. I said, man, fill this out. Get you a job or something, man. You know, I asked him if he had a telephone number. He said no, because I was going to tell him, you got a telephone number. Give me your number. And when we get up and start rolling, doing some work, I'm going to call you to come work with us. If you for real and serious. But you know they probably don't want to work. And stuff like that, man. But Democrats, man, god damn, man, be careful what you ask for. You just might motherfucking get it. And when you get it, you probably don't want it. Or you don't even know what to do with it, man. But I'm telling you guys, man, we have to write Congress, write your state representatives and everything. Have them to really dive into the data and look at the numbers. More people get killed with handguns than AR-15s and AK-47. A whole lot of people don't even like AR-15s. A whole lot of people don't even like AK-47s. They like 9mm. They like 40s. They like 45s. So, you know, like I'm saying, you trying to ban high-capacity magazines. When the guy in Virginia Tech, he killed 30-something people with a 9mm and a 22 pistol. No AR-15, no AK-47, no Draco, no AR-15 pistol. He just had, what, four or six magazines for a 9mm, and then he had a 22 pistol, and he was able to kill all them people, you know. But I guarantee you that if you would have had a couple of students that could have had their guns there, when he would have heard motherfuckers shooting back, it would have changed his whole POA, his whole plan of action, to where he's thinking, now I gotta cover my ass, I gotta move, I gotta, you know, vacate the premises because it could be shooters coming from me. You know, we just need people to use an educated guess and really dive into the data and the numbers to see what the fuck is really going on, not taking somebody that just coming and spewing shit or sending out mass emails or getting on television trying to get you to think like them. Think for yourself. Think for yourself. But this your boy Pundit, man. I'm out. I'll talk to y'all later. Be safe. Later.